everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today's topic is constant encoding igniters. So I will show you how to define them and how to use them. So let's get started. Now in encoding igniter we have some by default constant defined in our constant file that is present in config folder. So let me open that. So in this file you can see some predefined constants are present here. So you can see here file and directory mode constants are present. After that there is file stream modes are present and at last exit status codes are present. So these are some predefined constants that you got in encodeigniter constant file. So to define constant in encodeigniter it's the same way as in PHP using define keyword. So define takes two arguments. First one is name and second is value. So let's write first one, let's say website name, and let me pass value as knowledge thrusters. So now let me call this constant in home controller. So write echo website name. So in browser you can see its value is printed, that is knowledge thrusters. Now let's take an example, like you want your roles to be fixed. Let's say for admin you want 1, for HR let's say 2. So you can define these in constant. So write define admin let's say 1, after that write HR 2, and third one let's say manager 3. Now let me echo this in controller. So write echo admin. After that write echo HR. Now let's check in browser, refresh. Now you can see 1 and 2 is printed. 1 is for admin and 2 is for HR. So in constant you can also define array. Let's say weekdays you want same in your complete project. So it's a good way to define them in your constant file. So let me write, let's say define weekdays, and in array pass all the 7 days name, Monday, Tuesday till Sunday. You know, constants are helpful when let's say at a later stage you need to change something. So you can just go in constant file and you can just directly change it there. You don't need to go to a particular file and change your code there. Now let's print this weekdays. So write echo pre and print r weekdays. So now let's go and check in browser. So refresh, now you can see array is printed here with its index. So it's working fine. So now let's pass our own key using associative array. So let me just copy weekdays and paste. So here write, let's say status, remove all the elements. So first key I'm going to pass, let's say is 0 for pending, then 1 for approved and 2 for rejected. Now let's print this in controller, print our status, and let's check in browser. So refresh, now you can see 012 with pending, approved and rejected. Status basically is printed as we have defined in our constant. So I have shown you how to define and how to use constant in your code. I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.